I see that there are a few comments in the chat. Kim, are you able to see those?
Yes, I can.
Okay, so it's from Sadiqa Dawood, and she says, this is a great solution, Kim. We have an excess of teachers in South Africa. I like the idea of PD. I think she means professional development. Is that right, Sadiqa?
Yeah.
I mean, that was really interesting, that question also, because I was wondering about the teachers. A lot of the times there's this misconception of teachers in South Africa who aren't good enough, who don't know what they are doing, who aren't knowledgeable. And I'm sure that that takes a toll emotionally on teachers. You know, I wonder if we had teachers who are excited and who feel confident about what they're doing, that surely impacts their teaching of mathematics too. So capacity development really is essential, you know, building confidence in teachers so that they feel capable enough to take on the job that's in front of them. So thank you for that. There's another question coming from Tristan, who says, on a side note, I believe that SpaceX is currently working towards a global internet provided through CubeSat Starlink. In addition, what is everyone's take on utilizing the Flying Eye Hospital Orbis approach to providing education solutions to very rural communities? Kim, do you want him to expand on that, or do you want to respond to that?
I might just have a guess at what the Flying Eye Hospital Orbis approach might be, and then Tristan can correct me if I'm completely wrong. So is that where some eye specialists fly into remote communities to work their magic? Is that what we mean, Tristan? Is that the model?
So essentially the Flying Eye Hospital, if I remember correctly, it's an aircraft that was donated for humanitarian type of missions, and it was outfitted as a hospital, and it flies with us volunteer specialists to remote countries to give people the gift of sight, essentially. So I was thinking, what would your take be on having, say, for instance, a big company put out a bit of money to also maybe outfit an aircraft and then fly it into rural areas and offer it as a sort of makeshift school?
That's an idea I hadn't thought about in quite that way. But in terms of professional development for teachers, I think the idea of taking the professional development to the teachers is definitely a good idea. I know rural teachers that I've talked to all over the place, when they talk about, certainly in New South Wales, all the professional development opportunities are in Sydney. And if they want to come to Sydney, it's a day of travel at least to get there and a day of travel to go back. And so the school's got to find a replacement person for 3 days, just for one day of PD. And so that just makes it hugely difficult. So I get, again, technology's part of it, but I said to someone in the education department just recently, in fact, if we use technology to deliver professional development to rural areas, why couldn't we have the presenter actually in the rural school delivering it online to people in Sydney? just for a change. That would be kind of fair. So, and I have been part of a project a few years ago now where we actually got a team of us together, some university people and some education department people, and we actually liaised with a group of schools in a rural area about what their professional development needs were in maths, and we prepared a whole program for a fortnight. And we all travelled there and lived there for a fortnight and gave them all kinds of PD, from one-on-one demonstration lessons to after-school workshops to group planning meetings with grade groups across the schools and all kinds of things for an entire fortnight, which almost killed us. But it was great for the schools. It meant that we were sort of there with them in their context, and they didn't have to do all that travel, and they got great PD. So that's probably the closest I've seen to that sort of model. But I think definitely ways of getting PD to those teachers instead of expecting them to do all the travel or all the sitting at the end of the camera instead of in the live venue makes a lot of sense.